Good evening, everybody. It's me, it's Shad, PolyNerdic. We're back. We took last week off for mental health reasons. We have not streamed since the 11th of April. It is now the 19th of April, so it's been 8 days. It's been a little over a week since we last streamed Disco Elysium, and we're going to get back into it tonight. If you caught that stream on the 10th, you know that we had technical difficulties that caused a loss of an hour of gameplay due to the autosave not saving regularly and my failure to save manually. I've replayed through all of that. We are now at the point that followed where the game broke. We had our debriefing with Lieutenant Kim, and now we are in a dream sequence. Let's get into the game. I don't normally stream on Monday night, so I want to get as much in as I can. Let me turn this down, though, because it is rather loud. We are in this weird dreamscape. We still have our plastic bag. Oh, it's me. What the hell? The disco ball.
You remember the scent of your childhood. You're not kidding anyone, Harry. You don't remember shit. Did you remember your wife's hand on your face? Do you remember the warmth? Between her legs and in her mouth. That's right, Funky Baby. And you just stood there. One hand on the bottle and the other on your dick. Watching her go. Let it all be dragged away from you.
Hey, Bounty Hunter. Not much. Playing on a Monday night. I normally don't.
Magnetosphere, burning, furious truth, 8,000 years of written history.
Yeah, I played it, the last time I played it was on the 10th for a couple hours.
You really dropped the ball, Harry. 4.6 billion people, and you failed every single one of them. No, you're just sleep talking, and the act is wearing thin, too. The spots on the disco ball fade around you. You'll be back in those cold snakeskins in no time, sweating up the bed.
Stinky boy.
You're not coming back from shit. Thrashing around in that high conductivity state of yours, bumping into things and acting like a clown? Who are you kidding? You're trying to what? I can't hear you. This is just a word dream now. Jumbled up garbage. The pictures are gone. The bed rises to meet you. A thin, sleep-like state. More glass than velvet. Grinding in your head.
So something is wrong. Sleep shouldn't be this bad, this dry, this unnourishing. There's something wrong with your thoughts. Some kind of new type of hangover.
All right, that's fine. I appreciate the lurk for you know, having me in the background. I am absolutely fine with that. I'll have long moments of silence myself as the plot plays out.
Oh yes, party boy, and it's worse than the one before. Just think of the shit you saw. Here it comes too. So soon already. The silent alarm goes off in your head like clockwork. Barely let you sleep at all. Time to get those clothes on, Harry. Time to go to work in the shit factory.
Been there before. There we go.
Good going, buddy. Oh, just a dream. You have ones like that all the time. You feel even worse this morning than you did last night. You mean, why are you so tired? Too tired and down to even think. It is worrying, isn't it? You can't be a detective like this. Detectives need to be able to think. It's just that your heart has finally pumped all the speed out of your system, Buster. Time to get some more.
No, no more speed.
Too weak to say no. Waking up is the worst part. Maybe somewhere down the line you could decline. Are you sure? Ready to live as this pathetic shell of yourself for days?
Yeah, we're not doing drugs, man.
Let's be honest. 2 weeks. Maybe 3. You won't make suit yourself. Slow, sad shell man. See how you do without your spark.
Okay, still can't open that door. It's been a week, so I gotta get used to the controls again. Not out here. You play as a detective who has amnesia, doesn't even know who he is, doesn't know where his gun is, doesn't know where his badge is at the beginning of the game. There's a murder, and you're trying to solve it, and also figure out who you are. And you're in like a weird failed Soviet state. Like there was a communist revolution that failed. And the world's kind of in a crap spot as a result. We're not very far into the story at this point. Okay, the lieutenant needs to talk to me.
Morning. Looks like we can get to work at once. The union mess will turn up. They look rowdy. You should talk to them. I mean, ungovernable. Martinez isn't exactly enthusiastic about the RCM being here. They prefer to be policed by the union. These men here, men who drink beer. beer for breakfast? There's talk of an armed wing of the Union called the Hardy Boys, who are responsible for siege policing. I think it's them. I completely forgot. Sorry, I had a rough night's sleep. It's them by the looks of it. Loud and nasty, just like the manager said. One little thread left to worry about. One big problem to replace it.
Alright, we can do skill point.
One more thing before we do. We don't have to talk to them immediately. We can walk right past them.
Yeah, streetwise. Zoom right past. Do it on your own terms. But aren't you curious to know what they have to say?
And then, like, his different parts of his brain and personality chime in just like that all the time.
They're in no hurry to me. They think they own the place. Anyway, I leave that choice to you. Whatever you decide is fine by me.
Yeah, we'll talk to them on our terms. Not just because they're here. And I'm carrying around a plastic bag because it lets me pick up bottles that lets me turn them in for change. And it's all done in like a very tabletop RPG way of dice rolls and checks. What do I want to level up? We'll do authority. New save. To the Union. That guy's a racist. Actually, let's trade in any bottles we have. That note that, there we go. Whew. That high-pitched squeal was getting annoying.
The tear machines. Your bottles closed.
See? 80 cents.
You see several packaged raincoats fill a little shop.
The PlayStation controller is definitely not the way to play this. I wish I was playing it on PC. I never say that, but I wish. Yeah, I didn't like it. Very annoying. The rain sounds okay. Let's go deal with these Union guys. This way. Get permission to go in by talking to the big guy.
Man has humiliated, emasculated this complex
This guy's terrible. Guy's an a-hole. Alright, let's see if we can get past this part now that we have the healing that we needed before that we didn't have. There's that note again. It isn't pleasant. There we go. I wish I'd stop doing that.
Yes.
Let's see. Investigate all this. Yeah, we'll take that. Interesting.
It's unfortunate for the Union to just leave the paperwork lying around like this.
The drawer opens smoothly. Inside is a well-organized selection of brown folders. Hundreds of documents containing logistical data. Two kinds of transactions stand out. Materials coming into Revision from the outside world, from Windy, Grog, and even Ilmala. And the same materials being handed over to companies inside Revshaw, Kuron, Cold City, Delta, and Jamrock are listed among the many districts where the imports are being sold. It's hard to make sense of this thicket of company names, dates, quantities, and percentages. You try to focus, but the lines are getting blurry.
Try it. We failed.
The lines on these papers are how unwieldy. You're like an absurd Samaran monk, focusing through your focus. Hermeneutics was almost within your grasp, but now only vague letters float before your eyes. Less meaningful. You're a police officer, not a spiritual being. You can focus the normal way by turning your attention to something and not letting go.
Is that what you're doing with those folders over there? My thought exactly, officer. Shall we?
You're trying hard, but the data here is unbelievably dry. Hundreds of documents and the same materials mean you already went through all of the drawers.
Yep, we can't do it. We failed.
An imposing combination of a punch clock and a payphone is looking down at you.
Giant ass print on the pillow. Alright, let's go. Let's go talk to the union leader. We'll get past it this time. Because I brought healing. A couple weeks ago, the first time we played this, I did not bring healing. Couldn't get past this part. Get my
coat.
As your fingers touch the tarpaulin, it almost feels like the cloak wants to deliver.
Excuse me. Okay, yeah, it wasn't a communist revolution, it was a communard.
To your disappointment, there aren't any full color pictures to direct your attention. No advertisements, you notice. So who's funding this radical commentary? After rifling the pages with your thumb, the magazine is divided into several sections. Comrade, as you know,
just gonna skip through this real quick. Yeah, it's important. The small details.
This session includes a long, tedious critique of the latest round of free trade negotiations. You also skip over an article about heavy facet. You really aren't interested in foreign. You flip back to the front. It takes a moment. Obviously, because it's cool. As you leaf through this section, you come up with the main feature, though, is the tip-top toy is an inter-isolari. This so-called artist spotlight is really just a brief Q&A, made all the briefer by the subjects. You think you're settling in for a relaxing recap of the moment. Instead, you find yourself skimming a 10,000-word feature about all the politically problematic aspects of tip-top toy. Where to even start? For one, there's the crass commercialism of its sponsorships, and then there's the practically criminal emphasis on deadly motor crashes. So, all of it, basically. Oddly enough, this article has two bylines. There's no way those are. Have you ever met anyone named Exodus? Come on, they're plain pseudonyms. Under capitalism, the article says,
people who made this game definitely have a political leaning. This game is very, 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 very blunt about its hatred of capitalism.
I can safely say the thought had never crossed my mind, detective. I'm sure most things are, Mr. Youngman, who wrote this article, have to be believed. If I had to wager, I'd say they've never even seen the inside of a motor, much less a motor race. I take whatever they write with a light grain of salt.
You flip back to the front Unsurprisingly, much of this section is taken up with articles declaring unqualified support for the dock workers' strike. You skim the headlines. Paint the harbor red and white. Martinez tames the walk. Finally, there's a brief article by the writer, G. Martin, accusing the owner of the Cape Side apartments of illegally evicting certain communist tenants simply for not having paid. According to these editorials, there can be no accommodation with the forces of intent. Judging from the context, it's something you flip back to the front of the
put the magazine away. Hold on, wait. We got something going on here. It's the tasks. That's that. Won't let me go to the other one just yet for some reason. Here we are.
Self-critique. Here it is. Hard facts from the man you are. You once jerked off in the locker room and were caught. You held a young woman by the arm and kept her in your apartment.
Oh, you're a piece of crap.
What's this? We're getting reports of normal, reasonable, temperate, political opinions somewhere in Martinez. The air suddenly feels calm, more transparent in a strangely tender way. Perhaps it's the hangover. Perhaps it's a temporary surge of serotonin, but something tells you it's time to become a citizen of the Kingdom of Conscience. It is not a place. It is a moment in time that can only arise in the right circumstances. In all of human history, it is, isn't it? History's greatest catastrophes have been brought about by people trying to make the world a better place too quickly. That's the genius of Dolores Day. She recognized that progress is meaningless if its gains are lost because of instability. Real, lasting change can only come about gradually. Increment, tisk tisk. Just because you live in the present doesn't mean you have the right to place your needs above the needs of the future. You may never live to see the Kingdom of Conscience. Your children may not. What rationality? What sin for? The kingdom is difficult to comprehend, partly because humanity will need to discard many of the categories that define and limit it today. The kingdom of conscience is post-capitalist, post-national. It's also post-industrial, post-ideological, and even post-sexual. Slow down, Mr. Reasonable. Did you miss the part about compromising and taking things slowly? Right. Remember, real democracy is just around the corner from the show. When that real democracy kicks in, a long time from
okay. Okay, so we need to unlock new slots before we can increase that. See, take the bottles. Change these in later. It's a gold mine right here.
This is the night watchman's booth. Listen, it's okay to take a few minutes to yourself. Sit
if you must.
Nothing incriminating catches your eye. The cat looks like the inhabitant is wrong. This is a black and white photo of a young couple out in the...
Why did you take that picture of me? You are really interested in that old soldier.
The chair is not as awesome. You stand and hit.
All right. We're gonna survive this time because we have healing, unlike last time. Make our way around. Go look at the thing. What do we have here? We had something for a second. Where'd it go? There we are. Had to find the right spot to stand. I thought this was highlighted earlier. There it is. Exactly. Money's hard to come by, man. I barely have enough money for one more night in the hotel. Gotta find all the coins. Excuse me. I apologize for the constant burping. I've got some indigestion tonight. I need my crowbar. Put it in my left hand. Ah, wait, forgot. There we are. Ooh, got better gloves. Let's take them, or different gloves. I can't necessarily guarantee they're better. Yeah, it's just gross on my end because it tastes terrible, and I don't like the sound of it constantly. I'm drinking the carbonated water to try to get it all out because it's been all day.
The lyrics to this container song are being made up as he goes along. The accent is so thick, it's impossible not to notice he's moving from the vanishing peninsula.
Alright, cool, we got an autosave this time. There we go. I'm gonna go talk to the boss man. heading on up. Big old huge fat guy with an uncomfortable chair in front of him. Damn, that's an uncomfortable chair.
By the way, I heard you got a rather rude reception from a certain Lawrence Gart. Some people have no manners, it pains me to say. This should take care of that nonsense. It should be sufficient to cover your expenses for a few days and patch over your differences with a cafeteria manager. Go ahead, take it.
Wow, that's 25 real. That's good money. You need it.
Okay. I respect a man with principles. No handouts, then. Now, I'd like to set your mind at ease about one other matter. Your lost gun. Let me assure you, Union people are on it as we speak. I've got my best hound looking for that.
The Union's gonna find it.
His slug-like lips move, but all you hear is an echo. Lost gun. Lost gun. Lost gun. The world is swallowed by a black hole of fear. Only two words escape its gravitational pull. Lost and gun. When he said, don't worry, he actually meant, be very worried.
Are you all right, Harry? You say you've got this, but you seem a little anxious to me. Don't be. Everything's going to be all right. It's not like you left it lonely. You didn't lose a loaded gun.
Or did I?
People aren't out there playing with it right now, pointing it into their own mouths. It's in a safe place. I just know it. I have a feeling everything's going to be all right.
It was loaded. There were two bullets in it. You always keep at least two barrels loaded.
Officer, we will deal with this later.
I wouldn't be so sure about that.
Who does this guy think you are? Ronnie the Rookie? You ain't worried about no lost gun.
Ain't worried about no lost gun.
You're the bad cop. You're probably more corrupt than him. The fat man does the same, sinking deeper into his chair than one would think is physically possible. He seems to be enjoying your little display. Good. Now lean in with some corruption.
That we do, Harry. Let them say what they will about you and me. We're both born fighters. Why, thank you. It's always nice when a fellow professional appreciates your work.
That's it. Now kick back and add a final flourish for Big.
Strike me as a reasonable man, Harry. I like that in a lawman. Let's cut to the chase, shall we? What can Everard Clare...
Hey, we survived the conversation.
I think we'd like to ask you a few questions. you think so, Detective?
Whatever you do, don't ask him about the gun first. You don't want him thinking you're scared.
What? Harry, how could you say that to me? You know I appreciate a joke as much as any jolly fat guy, but I can't take slander. I'm actually investigating this.
The reaction appears to be sincere, but it's impossible to tell with this guy.
Harry, you wound me, Harry, in the heart. But I trust you to put this to bed. Do what you must.
He's hiding his real reaction beneath courtesy.
Thank you for your understanding. We will continue to do what we must.
You too, Lieutenant. You know, I like you. But you never were my...
I'm a hairy guy. I'm Team Harry.
I'm Team Harry.
I'm a hairy guy is a funny sentence.
I'm taken. Do we have anything else to do here, Harry?
Oh, that's very nice. I haven't gotten around to her yet. I'm very, very busy, you see. I hope you're getting along. One thing I want to make very clear, Harry, is that this is not some kind of union versus corporation situation. Everyone is just pals here. Yes, we're all trying to do what's best for Martinique. Don't feel like you shouldn't work with her just because you and I are such good friends. I'm not a jealous guy. What do you mean, Harry? Nothing. I let him go. He's an old man, Harry. I wanted him to spend more time with his family. God knows how long he's got left. Harry, I have little people in my organization. I would never call someone a midget. What is this? Honestly, I'm beginning to think you're a midget, Harry. I'm only kidding, Harry. You're not a midget. No one is. We're pals. If she actually wants to see me, she will find a way. Any good negotiator would. And I just don't have anything to discuss with a bad negotiator.
It's a fortress. He knows she can't get
it. Yeah, I was gonna say, he absolutely knows that.
He doesn't want to see her. It's as simple as that.
Vanished? Harry, the woman left her casserole in the oven and couldn't make it here in time for the voting. Oh, did I leave my casserole on? Better go home and check. The election can wait. When she got back, the whole thing was over.
Well, that's sexist as hell.
Wait, there was no mention of a casserole from Joyce.
Harry, Harry, Harry. Do not fixate on this little matter. Maybe it was a rabbit stew, or a hairdryer, or an iron. The point is, her heart wasn't in it. Mine was.
This particular brand of humor he has, it makes for a fine distraction.
Of course, Harry. Let me just assure you one more time. It's perfectly okay to share anything we discuss here with this Joyce. This is a completely transparent organization. I have no interest in what she is doing, but I myself have nothing to hide. Your business is your business, and I respect your privacy. Just remember...
He's belaboring that point.
Tell her about all of it. My brother's picture, my singing swordfish clock. Tell her how overweight I am and how I'm helping you find your lost gun. Tell her about everything. Everard doesn't mind.
It is rather interesting to tell people things about each other, isn't it? It was nice telling him about her right now.
Of course. Let us dispatch with the formalities. My God, so it's true. I didn't want to believe it, but you are a fantastic science fiction amnesiac cop, aren't you? What are the odds of that?
I think the odds of that are very low.
It might be a good idea to hide your confusion. I mean, see what his game is.
So good to hear that, Harry. Apparently, my sources were wrong. However, if you did have a spot of memory trouble, I could help you out with my big fat folder.
Words flow like a river of honey from his lips. I guess word has already reached him. No matter. No harm done. It's just the brown folder. You can't make out what's written on it.
Are you trying to tell me you've gotten hold of some of our documents?
Mr. Kitsunaragi, would you mind? Me and Harry are talking about his lost identity right now.
Don't just jump to the folder. That's not smart. Shows you're on the edge. Do some probing first. Everard's large hands are covering the folder, but the look on his face says, I know everything about you.
Oh, Harry. Oh, wow. This is really something.
I'm sure it's not that bad. It's worse, he has an old RCM folder, and I very much doubt even that.
So how about it, Harry? You need assistance, I presume? Of course, Harry, of course. Let's not linger on personal details and amnesia. Oh, of course. That's your main thing here. That's why you're in Martinez. I know everything that goes on around here, and I would love to discuss it with you.
I'm sure.
I mean, it's no secret that the lynching is connected to the strike. So much to talk about. Honestly, it's been weighing on me so heavily. I understand you need to interview, but there's a thing that's been keeping me up at night. I want to talk about the hanging. I mean, if we could just calmly talk, exchange information, we could blow this thing wide open.
Yes, that sounds good. Let's do that.
But I can't think straight with this thing weighing on me. You're police officers, aren't you? I have a crazy idea. You guys are basically door-opening machines, incredibly talented at opening doors. And I'm sure you're going to open this one with flying colors, Harry. This really is very simple, and there's nothing shady about it.
I don't trust you. That's the whole point, though.
Presents itself, sire. You could win the trust of the Archliar, pretend to play into his hand. Then, should you wish, bend his efforts towards your own.
Oh, no one's. It's just a weasel. A weasel lives there. Nothing for you to worry about. A loud, blubbering weasel. When weasels feel no one is watching, just go there, unlock the door, and leave it open. It's been such a burden on me, Harry. I just want this to be over so I can discuss business with you. Harry, I'm a very busy man, and more importantly, I don't have that extraordinary physique you do. You look...
You want to send someone a message that the police are working for you.
I repeat, I'm a very, very busy man, Mr. Kitsunaragi, and therefore I must occasionally enlist... Outside, Harry, my dear friend, I am what people call a local bigwig. I know everything that goes on in Martinez. Fantastic, my friend. Just let me know when it's done and we can check our friendship. You can get the key from Manana. He's down by the gates. Manana's like a free agent in the Union. Special operations. Hardened socialist. A real free thinker, too. He'll tell you precisely where the door is. One last thing, Harry. Just open the door. You don't need to go in or anything. I just want that weasel to come home and see the unlocked door. Yes, your lost gun. My best men are on it. They're turning every stone, searching every playground, asking kids, grandmas, everyone. Your gun will be found, Harry.
The only way to find it seems to be working with him. He might even...
Harry, I was only trying to be tactful. A lost gun. Kids could be playing gun roulette with it as we speak. Teenage gangs could be arming themselves.
I assure you, we are working on locating.
Excellent, Mr. Kitsunaragi. That's honestly, I didn't want to bring it up, Harry. I heard you have become Measurehead's race pupil. Of course, Harry, of course. You're not some kind of a fantastic race. No one's going to know what you did with race there, Harry. Your race bonanza is safe with me. Word of how racy it got will never leave Martinez.
Good use of the word racy.
Anyway, I assure you, I am a very well-informed wait. You need this to get in and out through the gate. Here, you're one of us now. A real red and white unit.
All right, we made it to that conversation this time that killed us the previous time. killed us. Our morale got too low and we quit. More money. I see it right there. There we are. Constantly clicking the right stick. Look for the things I can click on, like that. What's going to be inside?
Is this like your thing with that wall again? You do? Because I don't. There are a million containers here. Why are you fixating on this one? It's a cargo container, Detective. Just like all the others. We are not here to interact with containers.
You attempt to turn the handle to know it. To your left, the lieutenant considers your actions. With some puzzlement, no reply. The knock produces a hollow ring of metal. Doesn't sound like there's any.
Okay, we can't do anything with it just yet. Collecting the rainwater. It's illegal in some places. We get to exit. Couldn't exit this area without that key card. Couldn't get the key card without surviving the conversation. Couldn't survive the conversation last time. But now we've done it. It's my favorite snack. I really dig like a bowl of fruit. You know, some... like some grapes and strawberries and stuff. Raspberries. I used to be a nacho guy. Like, you know, Doritos and whatnot. But diabetes will knock that right out of you. Also, used to love, like, Reese's Pieces and Reese's Cups.
You've been in there. You
right. You talk to the boss eye to eye, like men of the plane. A key, huh? What door is this key supposed to open? Oh, say no more. I got you. I got that key right here. And let me tell you, it's mighty good of you to help us out during the strike. Working class solidarity, as they say. Polar Weasel? Oh, I know what you mean. What you're looking for is a basement door behind the
My racist friend, whoops.
That's all I know. Our organization is what you call compartmentalized. Means we...
Okay, but where did you get your key from?
The janitor gave it to me. Nice fella. We talked about life and things that really, truly matter. None of this mess worrying. This jiving and juggling. What's it for? To feed our children, I guess. I'm more of a philosophical dog worker. I like to talk about the big picture stuff. Who I am.
He means he's not going to tell you, because he doesn't know. But he will shoot his mouth off at you now that you're working for Everhunt.
We're negotiating our share. Aye. This stuff. They're already covered. The wolf always wants more. I like wolves. All of it. However, right now we want all the harbor workers to be on the company's board, so they could take part in the decision-making process.
Yeah, not being part of the process sucks.
Sounds like communism. Just so we're on the same page, communism is basically wanting to kill the rich people, or deporting them to a labor camp in Southeast Iran. But don't say that out loud if you're a communist.
I think it's best you make up your own mind now that you've met him. In my eyes, he is a capable organizer and a decent businessman. He's probably in his container at the harbor. So head right on in there. Sure thing.
This was great. You feel mentally reinvigorated.
The mercenary, eh? Who could have killed him? That's indeed the question. Why even do so?
The man whispers.
Now we go talk. No, come on. Go down. Down. There we go. Gonna go, gonna go, gonna go.
Something. He stole these employees' goods, and another lorry man's job. Listen up, fuckwits. You don't scare me. You cops don't run the Vacher West. You don't run Martinez. You don't run it.
No. He means La Puta Madre.
A legendary, and not in a good way. Crime boss from Jamra. Controls what is probably the most powerful organized crime outfit in Revachol West.
Hmm.
Yeah, him.
Then I presume you are familiar with his peonies.
Yeah, they're his little bitches. He's got them all over the unions.
Not just the unions. He has peonies everywhere. Some say he even has them in the RCM. Dirty fucking peonies would do anything for him. Multi-ethnic drug addicts.
Playing as racism, man. That's great.
The lieutenant dots a rodent time quality. Be cool, sire. He's getting into this.
You're not peonies. You wouldn't be investigating a drug thing if you were.
No, of course not. We are not peonies. But if we were, and one of Madre's drivers were to be stealing from him, then it's a good peonies job to find out who that is.
He's surprisingly good at this. Not bad at all. Look at him lurching.
It's not a hard job. It won't take a long time. It won't make Padre Madre angry. But his
father, mother,
fucking racist is standing in the way, protecting this fucking thief.
I'm not scared of you or the mob. I'm under the protection of the Lorrymen and Carters Guild.
You've seen the carts in the yard, yes? You took a peek. I know you did. Does it look like his friends protected him?
Nah, you wouldn't just leave him out there if you...
The lieutenant turns and gives you a barely perceptible nod. Be careful. This man still must have fighting him by the looks of it. It would be easy to break him. The main thing is to not overdo it, even when you're trying to scare someone. The most important thing is, how does it look on your resume?
What? What do you think we're doing right now, runt? We're outside. There's some kind of homo thing? Make me.
We just have to ask someone else about the lady driver. Let's go.
Damn. Messed it up. Messed it up. Took a double morale hit, darn. Sell some more bottles. Make another 80 cents.
The tear machine stands in the corner. Your bottles clump into the machine.
Hey, got a whole dollar this time. It was good to be playing this game. I was playing Don't Starve last night. I'm starting to enjoy that game more and more every time I play it. Made like a whole 11 days this time. And counting. Let's go talk to the union a-holes.
Different today. Less hospitable.
You are far from home, Lieutenant. This isn't a district known for its love of self-proclaimed militiamen.
Not a muscle moves in her face, but her eyes trace yours, stern and perceptive.
You are looking for Titus Hardy, who you think has information on a murder the RCM is investigating. You want to interview him. That's Titus. Talk to him, but know this. I'll be keeping an eye on you. No strong arming, nothing official. The district of Matthew does not recognize your authority.
So they would stop me from making the arrest?
It doesn't matter if you recognize our authority. We will make
Yeah, you get him, Kim. Titus. Yep.
This is where you say you're here.
Detective.
Wow. The RCM sent us some big
swinging in the wind.
Yeah, look at the big dick on that cop. Can't tell a dick that big what to do.
Must be something in the water to jump up.
Yeah, gave real nice big dicks.
Yeah. Anyways.
You might want to start asking your questions now. It's not going to get better than this.
So, you're not just here to swing your big dick. You're here for the pretty boy.
Stinks like shit, too.
They couldn't get him down, boss. He's still up there, stinking up the place.
Honey, my partner and I have a serious matter to discuss with you.
Well, maybe you should just fuck off then.
Don't worry. We are resourceful. We find a good topic for us.
No. Eyes here. You got business with my boys. You got business with me.
He understood what you were doing. They're taking inventory of them.
Yeah! You fuck with the Hardy Boys, you fuck with Titus.
I like the voice acting in this game a whole lot.
Relax, Dennis. No one is fucking you yet.
Yeah, Dennis, calm down. No one's fucking you, stupid fuck.
Let Dennis enjoy his fucking, man. We don't mind.
Yeah. You're not even being fucked, Dennis.
Fat Angus.
Easy, fellas. We got company. Let's see what brings the cop around.
Too late to stop you. You've already got them all. Including the old bearded man who's smart enough to smoke instead of talking. As you can see, he doesn't speak a lot, and you almost missed him among the others. That's enough to take another look at those tracks in the yard. See if they fit this band of miscreants.
No.
He understood what...
Okay, so we do this whole thing again.
Let Dennis in.
Yeah.
Easy, fellas.
Too late to stop you. As you can see, that's enough to take another look at those tracks in the yard. See if they fit this band.
Incriminated.
Well,
don't worry. We are.
Go look at the tracks. It's a fascinating game. That way I don't think it's a new message. The tracks again.
There are several footprints in the mud, left by workers. Anywhere from 6 to 12 pairs have walked here. Well,
what?
Still not doing it. You're bad at this.
Don't beat yourself down.
Not it. Heavy workers' boots with reinforced toe. Isn't this something an industrial worker would wear?
That music note, series of notes, like, just is triggered by being in that area, I guess.
circus left town, but the clowns are still here. Incriminate.
No.
Don't worry. We are resourceful. We find a good topic for us to discuss.
Go back out to the crime scene, I guess. Investigate it again. See? Da-da-da.
There he still is, looking right through you with his white eyes. The body below is entirely dedicated.
Active decay.
Apparently there's a beer in England that has a beholder on its can. There, we need to get.
Oh, foot's falling asleep.
What's going on? Is an ungovernable youth on your crime scene, throwing around like you don't have enough on your plate? You feel a sudden surge of self-pity coming on. Explain yourself. As if explaining something. You must get to the bottom of this, one of them.
Thank you. Hmm. How do I investigate the belt around his neck?
There, he still is. Looking right.
Okay. I'll figure out who the heck Renee is. At this point, I don't remember. You're not Renee, are you? Coins on the ground. Yeah, some money. Where are you?
Small, wrinkled woman that does not greet you. She nods along to something. The photo. An ambrotype from the turn of the century, as golden as her smile. No response. Wherever this woman is, your words fail to reach her.
If you want her attention, you may need to be more forceful.
Where am I? Who are you? Never mind. I remember now. I'm still stuck in that traffic jam in the 50s. Back in Mexico, the time of the revolution. The sidewalks and cafes are filled with young people. I was on my way to see a new Voyadeiro picture starring Gabriel Bernier. Until you came along, and that is. I was in Bremen. I was there, Roman. It was early spring, and the mine behind the black sun had just come out. While you, people, were tearing each other apart over your petty little revolution, meth was a golden age.
The Republic of Mesk is a massive confederation under Isola of Lurindi, the world's largest state by territory. It's a petro-state, a constitutional monarchy, and, as of recently, outcast due to its tilt to the far right.
Why not, Harifa? It's not like I have anything better to do in this hellhole. Diamonds? Of course not. But wouldn't it be marvelous if I... Whatever stupid things they put in the lorry, I imagine. I quit concerning myself with that a long time ago. Besides, I don't drive the lorry for the cargo, if you know what I mean. Then it's contraband, woman. What? Do you want to take an old woman in? Be my guest. Lock me away like bad hand Hermenegildos.
Bad hand? Hermenegildos' bad hand strangled 300 people. What can I say? Some people just really like strangling people.
She's just a distracted old woman.
This game's phenomenal. Just sucks me right in.
So he doesn't think she's the lady driver.
You hear that, Roman? I don't think your partner likes you spending too much time with me. Appelled The great adversary, not Roxton. Yes. There is a protagonist and an adversary. I am on the side of the adversary. There's no coming back from that hole.
Those epithets are familiar somehow. The great adversary.
Interesting.
The great unrest. I don't like the sound of any of that. Sounds like a horrible drug. The woman sways her wrinkles.
Yes, go. Enough jumble.
Yes? What do you want to know? What do you want to know? Good.
Done. Okay. Navigating in this game sometimes is unnecessarily annoying. You're not Renee, are you?
Stuck in the rain in a traffic jam, man. What's on your mind?
Oh, this was Renee, isn't it? Is that Renee? Yep.
You're still waiting for a replacement to the pool you sent sinking. Yes. The Badil's union pays me to stand built during the night. Not out of any political allegiance, mind you. I'm an old man. Don't sleep more than a few hours every night anyway, and... Yes, it does. Unfortunately, I wasn't working that night. Been on a 2-week leave since last Monday. It's a private matter.
You see, officer, René is the kind of man would rather die than...
Just gonna ride it out.
...assistance, or, God forbid, take it. A real man's man is just gonna ride it out.
I'm fine, goddammit. Mind your own business.
Us has been on man since last Monday.
No one has been guarding the container yard since last Monday.
Yes. It's not actually an issue.
I look, officer. The container yard doesn't actually need a guardsman. Never had one before Monday. Monsieur Claire, at that who's built...
Oh, that's touching slash sad.
The possibility of someone being... enough to discourage any ill-minded individuals.
Pepa created this job for René because he knows the Royal Carabiniers' pension of honor and PTSD isn't something a man can live off. A decorated Kingsman collecting there reflects bad on the whole neighborhood. His world.
Conclude the topic of my girl. She is nobody.
Maybe is Jean-Marie Beaulieu, and she sure as hell wasn't a nobody.
Yes, yes. Like I...
What do you have to say, sir?
I have really outdone myself.
Yes, that's what you need, Gaston.
Hello, officer. How might I be of assistance on this fine day? Oh, sweet Jenny. She was the finest woman in all of Revachol.
Ooh, he was sweet on her, too.
The entire world.
Do not defile her memory, Gaston. Let her rest in peace.
We knew her, all right. We lived on the same street our entire lives, just two houses apart.
Oh, she's dead.
Two of us have been best friends since we were four. She was Ronnie's first girl back when the prick was 16. They were courting till he decided he'd rather die for some great ideal than just be happy.
And then you stole her from me.
Oh, officer. It already got ugly nearly 80 years ago when the three of us were just learning to walk and talk.
You stole her from me.
Well, technically, you stole her from me, because we've been pretty close ever since you two had that falling out over the ink you spilled over a pretty yellow dress.
Well, just boys then. This was different. You. No point starting this all over again. This is thousands and the first time. Especially when we have company.
She died of pneumonia 2 winters ago. It was a quiet passage, peaceful. Honey and I were both by her bedside when she
died. No use sugarcoating it. Don't bring her back. Feel it now.
Departed. Until the very hand she couldn't decide between us. The most indecisive woman I've ever met. She could never make up her mind about anything. What to have for breakfast, favorite color, or which one of us to marry. She was always leaving one of us for the other, but never long enough to actually get married. Heck, technically, we're both still engaged to her.
You always confused her. Couldn't let us be happy. Seduced her with your fancy world that they basically...
That's in itself not funny, but that sentence is hilarious.
Of course, officer. The memories are all we have left. Let me think. I heard someone was hanged and left on a tree for a week. But that's all I know, really. No, officer. I'm sorry.
Then help them, Wim. You have plenty of shoulder with your ghost caviar.
He means caviar socialist.
I wish I could, but I just don't know anything.
Odd. He doesn't seem to be lying, but there's something.
I'm not even anyone.
Of course he's holding back. His mouth is so full of union brick, he can't even speak properly.
Damn.
Can I at least finish my fucking sentence before you piss on it? Is that okay, Renee? I'm not anyone important in the union. I just know Eva. Everyone in Martinez knows the Claire brother. I taught this boy's human studies and history in the gymnasium.
What do you know about history? You never witnessed history. Only heard about it years later, when it had already moved on. You don't know history.
The old soldier mumbles something under his breath and turns to face the sea. There he stands, proud, rigid and alone, like a cracking marble statue.
Let's try not to get caught in a crossfire.
Oh, in many ways, yes. Like an honorary member. I attend meetings and parties, help with little things. Eva? Oh, yes. Not in the technical sense. I don't have a vote or a membership card. But Eva keeps me on the payroll, just for the little thing.
So that's what it was before. Him hiding something. He tries to make it look like he's a big deal in the union. And now the illusion is disintegrating for your...
Interesting.
Eyes. He doesn't know anything, because no one tells him anything. He's an outsider.
Of course he's not a member. He's not a member of anything. I knew that. He's a Vesavay. Don't know where the wind blows and tries to look important. I hate the socialist family. Even siding with them is better than living your entire life on defense. Never committing to anything. take a damn side already.
Writing work mostly. Occasionally, he needs something written, and I happen to have a way with words.
What did you write, Gaston?
Oh, nothing official, I assure you. Just essays for the newspapers. About Martinez and how things are and how they could be. Hevart and I had these long talks where...
Well, he tells the pen man exactly what to say. It's comic propaganda, plain and simple. You should be ashamed of yourself.
I don't even consider myself a regular socialist. Politics is not really something I involve myself in, officer. I prefer highly adaptable myself. Have a better ring to it, don't you think?
Yeah, it does sound better than weather vane.
Oh, you.
No, thank you.
Okay. Always looking for bottles to grab. Always want me to talk to him, but not give me bottles. Can we figure this out yet?
Just ordinary wall. Nothing to see here.
Yeah, we're totally going in. Why would we not? You always go in when you unlock a door. Especially when someone tells you not to go in. Sevenfold sun.
This is the sevenfold sun logo. It's an optical atmospheric anomaly. The first settlers saw happens in cold weather. Six small suns around the big one. This complex halo phenomena is how old Revachol got its flag.
The tenant is an old-fashioned guy.
By old-fashioned, he means very right wing. The flag doesn't seem to mind. It's just a colorful flag.
Yeah. We have a racist mug too. Aha.
The same humor, the same mocking lines.
There's the missing tin soldier. Whoever lives here might have used the wording's container to dump his trash. And now they've drawn the ire of the Union. The plot thickens.
An interesting little clue. Let's see where this goes. Clues have a way of magically connecting it to other clues down the road.
Who knows? I'm not expecting too much from this clothes in the trash lead, either way. It might turn out to be some random local matter. But still, nice coincidence.
You could ask Everard who this person.
Anything else in here, I guess? Double check everything. Yep. Feel better about intimidating whoever this person is for the Union.
Master investigator, you just can't keep yourself away from locked in places, can you? At a point, the world's secrets were made for you. They wait patiently for you.
Yeah. Damn straight. Alright, let's... So back to Everett, because too early in the day to try to talk to the balcony guy. Running. All the way back to where we were going.
The moon covers the white on blue police livery of the motor carriage. The white colors nearly meld together. Do something important? Something murder related? This is a Caprice Canema. The Caprice motor
car with an
air-cooled, rear-mounted 12-cylinder compression ignition engine driving the rear wheels through a four-speed manual gearbox. Look, even at the standstill, the unibody Caprice Canema looks sleek and dynamic. The cabin, someone has waxed it recently.
You want to take a closer look? 130.
I reckon that's a 7-liter V12 there. Man, that's got to be a major advancement over the KR18 GU engine on the old Capri.
Yeah, you know it? Yes, that's right.
All right, got a trophy.
Yes, an extraordinary machine.
It's nice and all, but why so nervous? Put some zing into it. Flare at helium headlights would improve the range and quality of the visual field a lot.
Actually, I have a pair at home. Just haven't gotten around to... You want to help? Thank you for the offer. That might be fun.
He liked the idea.
Boom! We're friends now! Yay! Made friends with Lieutenant Kim. Fuck that guy, he's a racist. Excuse me, union guy, excuse me. Oh wait, no, you're scabs. This is the union guy. Do. There's that fucking tone again, man. I wish I could select a specific song and turn it off. Cause that's just annoying. It's annoying as hell. No, wait, there was a... Where was it? Give it here. Come on, man. I saw it. There it is. Yeah, that's pretty obvious, man. Pretty obvious. It's old Everart, or what? However you pronounce his name. Evart. What did we pick up? Okay, we have three more things. I wonder if I have to do something with... I don't know. I don't know how to get the thought cabinets opened. Down.
You're back before the cargo container. Its draw has not let you attempt to turn the handle. To your left.
Still mechanically locked. Can't put points into Volition, game. You won't let me. Because of the way I built my character.
Mr. Dubois, a pleasure as always. You don't have to sit down this time, since you've already sat on that chair. My dear Harry, there are literally millions of containers in this harbor. Harry, you smooth-talking son of a bitch. Time is a precious resource, and I don't have enough of it to count containers with you.
True.
I'm very glad to hear that, Harry. One question. You didn't actually happen to stumble in and see what's inside the apartment, did you?
He's trying to figure out if you're lying.
You're right, Harry. You only had to unlock the door, which you did. So we're all good here.
He was testing you.
Now let's get down to brass tacks. It's time for men like me and you to figure out who's killed who and why. Real police work is going to start happening now. I promise you, Harry, this is going to be good. By now, I'm sure you've figured out who the dead man was working for.
The bad guys.
Wild kinds, sent to scare us. Another violent measure of the top hats against us black caps. Harry, this strike is the culmination of many, many mistakes made by the Wild Pines group. They tried to shut the strike down by sending in armed mercenaries.
You mean our victim?
A security contractor. Can you imagine that? Workers standing in peaceful protest, united in the spirit of fellowship, and they send hired killers to mow us down with machine gun fire.
He performs a motion as if spraying bullets from a machine gun.
I'm talking beasts, hardened killers from proxy wars in Yisu, Seminine, Salamaritza. You name it, they've done it. Raping, killing, burning villages, killing little children for the
sake of
the pineapple company, Harry. Everything they did there, they brought over here. They want to turn Revachol into a third world slum. Honestly, the only thing they did do is kill the village elephant. No, Harry, the elephant is metaphorical and so is the village, but the mercs and their brutality are very real. Now, I haven't personally witnessed the brutalities out there. I have the luxury of staying in my container, you see. If I need to go somewhere, they just move my container.
Ah.
Yes, I'm an old man, Harry. My legs aren't what they used to be. They lift my office with that big crane. It's actually very fun. You should try it.
I did earlier.
Enough about me and my fun container. The killers the company hired, I think there were three of them, all hardened commando types. One of them got downright suicidal, getting drunk, violent, a little rapey. Even their own negotiator couldn't control him. That's your boy, the one who likes hanging out and trees.
Wow. Downright rapey, he said. Wow.
By negotiator, you mean Joyce?
Harry, what you need to realize is, we dock workers are not pushovers.
Seems to be.
We got grit, Harry. This whole neighborhood does. Push us hard enough, and we push back. And when we do, we push to kill. Potentially, Harry, potentially. We got arm wrestling champions, rowing club people, ex-coal miners, tough guns, all ready to spring into action for their home base. There's a militant wing inside the union, a group of people whose duties don't involve manual labor, but peacekeeping in the neighborhood. Making sure everything runs smoothly.
That sounds a bit like organized crime.
They are like you guys. I people who want to make sure bad things don't happen.
The Hardy Boys.
They already have. Well,
That sounds like organized crime. Sorry, I was looking something up over here. Still am.
So the idealists killed our victim.
One day, Titus Hardy, leader of this peacekeeping faction, comes up to me and says,
"Hold on.
Socialist democratic fervor drove us to take it upon ourselves to kill this beast that was burdening the land."
Boss out of them.
He probably worded it differently, but that was the idea. Sure sounded to me like they killed him. I gave them 2 weeks paid leave and told them to lay low to avoid retaliation.
Aren't you worried you might arrest them for this?
No, I'm not at all worried about that. These are not the kind of men who get arrested. They're Martin A's boys, tough and gritty. I'd like to see the man who takes them in. Besides, I sent my lawyer girl to look after them.
He places a lot of faith in that lawyer girl. Perhaps this is a tactical error. Anyway.
How do I know? Let me tell you about these people. That's their MO. It's what they do.
It's what they do. Suppose I should have the chat up on the screen just in case. Oh man, that sucks. I just saw your comment about not being able to finish the quest. That's terrible.
The strike was over the workers' right to wear protective footwear, eh? These guys turn up and start beating people. Tell you what, Harry, I wouldn't be surprised if we got the same mercenary company after a little rebranding. And I'm sure as hell not surprised to see an army of scabs under my gates.
So you believe the scabs were organized by the security contractor?
You said it. Hell. One of those guys looks big enough to take down that proverbial elephant. Boys like that don't just happen to show up during strikes.
That does sound quite unlikely, yes. But the big guy leaving the scabs at the gate is colossal.
I get that. My little bit of time with Destiny was like that.
That Lord of Rhee myself, thinking it will probably turn her more fancy. But hell, Harry, she came back a firebrand socialist. Sometimes she scares me with her zeal. Oh, they are simply fine young men, all seven of them. Exemplary union members, always working to advance their position in the local socialist democratic movement. Core members. Old Theo used to run them, but things really kicked into gear when Titus took the reins and named the group after himself. Gotta love his initiative.
Interesting. Who's second in command?
They're almost all of them great guys, all leaders. Whatever happened, I'm sure they only have the best interests of Martin A.
He just outed them as the murderers. That's hilarious.
Work with them. Hell, interview them. But don't fight them. They really are just like you. Men who like beer, women, and some order on the streets.
He's betting on them being useless to you.
But of course, it's the least I can do for my good friend Harry. I'll do it right.
You can now go and tell Titus about this.
Also, Harry, here's 5 real. I'm not giving you anything. I'm just holding out 5 real.
The lieutenant watches you pocket the banknote. He looks a little puzzled.
Good boy. A real team player. Was it a good talk? I'm not sure we made much headway here. I was hoping we'd bust the case right open. I don't know what happened, Harry. I wanted you to feel like Mr. Martin Ains. And, of course, I also wanted you to find your gun. But it's like I can't completely trust you. Yeah.
This guy's such a weasel.
Yes, Harry. It's like I can't fully trust you if you're not a man of the left. I want to, but I just can't.
A man of the left? So you have to be a social democrat. He's been hurt too much in the past by men who aren't social democrats.
how it is. Company snitches, agent provocateurs everywhere.
And what would this entail?
Once again, I require nothing unethical or illegal of you. You just need to get two of the signatures on this piece of paper, and then mail it to my accountant in the Delta. I'm glad you asked, Harry. The union is going to build a modern youth center in Martin A. It will be right.
Get them off drugs and on roller skates.
There's a nameless little street on the coast and some old houses around it. Most people have already signed. I just need two more signatures to get this mission off the ground, Harry. On the coast, Harry, across the canal. There's a cul-de-sac there, a little village they're calling it.
You're already pretty deep into this. What's a little more? No one can see you here.
They are just going to have to deal with the construction noise for 6 months, and then they'll be living like kings. Right next to a fancy...
Is he absolutely sure the tenants won't be thrown out?
Am I? Harry, these people... Martin Ames is the most important thing in my life. I would never let anything bad happen to them.
Don't trust him.
We're going to build a youth center there. You bring joy to my heart, Harry. You need to get signatures from Isabel Sadie and Lillian Carter. The cul-de-sac is right past the pawn shop and across the canal. Once you have the signatures, mail this to 13022. See you soon, Debarger. Just kidding.
Hmm. Took the payment. I don't know how that's going to play out.
Now is not the time to get philosophical.
No reply. The knock produces a hollow.
I want to know what's in there. Just want to know. Oh, wrong way. I might go back to streaming on Monday nights. I don't know. I like using it as a painting night, but I also like streaming. I like streaming a whole lot.
Talk to the union, a-holes. Self-appointed police officers for the union. Takes forever. There we go.
Looks like the circus left town, but the clowns are still here.
Yep, absolutely, clowns. Clowns still here.
Seven honest men have equally come forth. They told you what happened, so that you don't waste any more of your time.
All seven together. They dilute responsibility. It's an anti-arrest tactic.
Are you deaf? There will be no singling anyone out. Do you think you could do that? Do you think you could arrest them?
A trick question. Don't let her lead the conversation.
Who do you fucking think does? You keep him the fuck out of this.
He didn't like that.
How many people have you sent to the Chaise?
Chaise Electrique is the method of capital punishment.
I like the idea of it being an electric chaise lounge. Chaise lounge.
It used to be the firing squad.
Jeez. Sword and sniper, no auto gun.
For send them to reunion to rot. For 20 years. Life.
But you see, a lawman, is something people agree upon. You hear Martin Hayes, we agree that this man had to die.
You don't have to keep answering his questions.
I know, Lizzie. Relax. You killed him last Sunday night. Seemed like a good way to handle it.
Known him? We don't associate with scum like that, asshole.
Yeah! Who do you think we are?
Quiet. He came around about 3 weeks ago when that Pines cow first sailed into town.
By the Pines cow, you mean Joyce Messier? The representative for White Pines? The same company you're striking against?
No. I mean Pines cow. The stupid-ass cow they sent in to fuck us over.
But you know what?
The one before?
Why don't you ask her about the pretty boy? I'm sure she has interesting things to say when you ask her hard enough.
That's enough insinuation for today, Titus. Officer, your interview is drawing to an end. Don't waste your last questions.
Why? Because he was worthless, mercenary scum. I am. He stepped out of line.
What kind of mercenary?
The kind that shows up when you start a strike. The experienced kind, too. That have cohorts disseminated written all over. Ex-Oranese Special Forces.
A live grenade! Right here in our bar!
I can't prove it, but I know he's sent by the Wild Pines. They hired a merch ship like that. Story of every strike from the Samara.
Because one night he walked straight up to the mic and said, I'm one of these goddamn special forces, and I'm gonna fuck you all!
Really?
Yeah, really. Had a gin and tonic up there, sang some Aranese paratrooper song, and said he's gonna fuck everyone.
We couldn't believe it either, but he fucking did, right there! Like some kind of animal.
Sire, the tale is true. This is a serious violation of the code. Strange the escalation. He regrets mentioning it. Hopes he didn't notice.
Kill us all. If we don't open the gates, if we don't let the scabs in, if we don't bend over. That was before he started coming here.
Yeah, he said it was his favorite joint now. Started coming here every night. Drinking, grabbing girls. Grab one of ours mid-karaoke, right there on the stage.
You grab someone?
Yeah. This girl's on the mic, a beautiful girl, young. Gets into the second verse of Love Lake, the fucker grabs her legs, starts screaming. Show me your cunt! Why don't you show me your cunt? Then, he gets knocked on the head with a wine bottle, doesn't even fall down.
Aren't you fucking listening? My man is talking to you. You took care of it. You think I figured it out before anything else could happen?
Yeah, me and Eugene got her out. Aren't you fucking listening?
There's something odd here. Seems like they don't want to talk about that rape Titus mentioned. Why not? This is a serious allegation. Make them talk about it.
No. You're not getting the name. That's a Martinez matter. I'm not discussing it with you clowns.
There's nothing you can do for now. He's stonewalling you.
We hanged him up by his neck until he got real still.
Bad way to go.
Didn't they teach you anything at the cop school, idiot?
This is where an autopsy would come in. You have to work with what you know.
Maybe wrap it up instead? Nothing. Your investigation here is done. Leave Martinez, go back to your stations where you belong.
I think we're going to stick around, thanks. Some things don't add up here, Titus. Done this job for long enough to know that people don't just confess to full degree murder, even if it is a group responsibility.
Good luck with that.
You've heard everything a random cop is gonna hear from us. Real law.
Forget about their games. You've mapped out the characters. Reading the footprints in the yard should be easier now.
Is it going to be easier this time, or is it still gonna fail on me? Let's see. Can't increase our authority anymore. Let's go ahead and save. Cam.
Shuffled back and forth in the mud. Where else have we seen a gang of men with work boots? That's right. The Hardy Boys in the mess hall of Welling and Rats. One. Standard work boot. Steel reinforced toes. Number 46. Just like Titus was wearing in his booth. This is the big pick. Titus Hardy. The one with the ball cap. Is it? They didn't even bother to change boots. Putting them on the scene is easy. Maybe even too easy. Two. Standard work boot. Steel reinforced toes. Number 44. Either the blonde muscular guy. Three. Hobnailed work boot. Steel reinforced toes. Number 43. Four. Standard work boot. Number 45 or 46. Theo.
Man, that's some sharp eyes.
Inside the print. Five. Another standard work boot. Reinforced toes. Number 44. Same as before. Either the musician, Eugene, or the muscle-bound blonde. Six. Light as air. Same make of boot. But number 41. Small like a rat. Seven. The glowing outline. The imprints are twice as deep as the others. The weight exceeds 200 kilograms. Fat Angus. Carrying something? Eight. Another standard work boot. Number 44. There's an aberration in the pattern of the sole. The right sole is smoother, more worn. Curious. A missing eighth Hardy Boy.
That's all? Interesting. Then one of them seems to be missing. Anything else out of the ordinary?
Note to self. This would be a good question to ask Titus. Where's the eighth man?
Interesting. Let's name it the Old Soul. I wouldn't be surprised if this was the missing Hardy Boy. Someone operating a workbench with a pedal? Like a joiner at the harbor? Or maybe a drummer? No, it's not. Forget it. Perhaps it could be a driver. A driver will wear out the right shoe before the left. The accelerator is on the right.
He doesn't seem to hear you. Looking south, toward the traffic jams instead.
We should keep our eyes open along the traffic jam. See whether anyone strikes out as a potential suspect. Seems prudent, no? I'm guessing that's the skinny Hardy Boy. The one with his front teeth missing. Yes, one of them. He did look a bit like a rat. I could still be wrong, but I'm probably not. 200? This could be the combined weight of two people, one carrying the other who's tied up. Let's say a heavily built worker carrying a similarly built armored man. Maybe it was a fat Hardy Boy, the one sitting in the middle.
He might be right. 200 kilograms of living weight is...
Possibly, yes.
But why?
Yes, they could have used a makeshift stretcher or just marching up to the gallows. Even easier to carry on a stretcher or between two men.
Cool, autosave, awesome. Who's your eighth Hardy Boy? It's a great name for a group of thugs.
circus left town.
You say it every time we come back, bud.
What are you talking about, Batman? There's no 8th Hardy Boy. There's 7 of us and we're all here. Or what? You want to be the 8th Hardy Boy? We ain't hiring.
Actually, boss, we've been talking and we think she could maybe...
She?
Ah.
So there's a 8th Hardy and it's a Hardy girl. Who might it be?
Ha ha! Dude opened his fat mouth.
Shut the fuck up, man!
It has to be good, if he...
So let me get this straight. There is an 8th Hardy boy. It's a she, and you don't like us talking about her?
That's right. We're not talking about this. This is a private Hardy boy's matter. Nothing to do with your shit. And you're not cops here. Don't go digging around if you don't want a bullet in the back of your head.
This feels like the kind of game where I certainly could take a bullet in the back of the head by the end of it.
Good. We are all watching each other. Officer, your question.
He's right. With a face like that, she could be on the cover of the Debutante International.
So fucking what? Lots of models are actually really smart people, fuckwad.
Use the fuckwad. Like it.
No, Glenn. They aren't.
This didn't change her opinion. It's not her. She's not a Hardy girl. Definitely.
Obviously, I'm a lawyer. A legal counselor for the Dock Workers Union. I would urge you to... What you want is of no significance, officer. What are we going to do to you? The union isn't going to do. If any...
Goddamn right it is.
Aggressive. You make your living enforcing violence.
Just dock workers. Do dock workers spy on me. We've talked to Iraq there. We know.
Listen. You morally unlucky. You're a mob. Enforcing the unlawful privatization of Revishop. 20 fat men in the Occident are stealing it all. And you're their bodyguard.
Fuck yeah.
So ask what you came to ask. Or get back to your commanders. Look. A comedian. Do your job.
Strange. It's as if people don't believe a cop clearly a socialist revolutionary.
This game's something. Load times, wish this was on a 5. That would be great. Alright. Sturdy woman.
Yes? Hello? Me? No one. I'm just a working class woman.
She doesn't really want to be disturbed. She's such a working class woman. Why isn't she working?
Looking for something to read. It is. I know you are. What with? My husband? No, I don't know. At home now?
Where is this going, officer?
Yes, but... No. Why are we still talking about
this? It's got to be something else, then.
No, absolutely not. Are you pleased, man? They are not missing, sir.
You know where they are. They're at home. No, they're at the disco. Getting it down. Stupid disco dancing teenagers.
What? That's just... My daughters are perfectly fine. They're almost grown up now, anyway. They're past the age they need me protecting them from everything. My youngest girl, Jolie, is just shy of 16. Jenny, she is turning 18 next month. Why do you need to know this? Haven't I repeatedly told you that they're not missing? There is no investigation here.
Okay. I wonder where this goes.
What are you doing here?
I don't mean to disrespect, sir.
For what it's worth, I agree. But cockatoos can't be stopped when they get ladies. It's better to judge him at this point.
I don't even have a cockatoo.
It's a trap. Never ever say what.
Even if I had, it wouldn't be great. Nothing. Go.
Maybe you should. What if the cockatoo is...
Wonderful. The store is open.
Her hands move over the book covers, the tips of her fingers, the woman before.
I can now go study my heraldic bird. I'm not familiar with such an expression. What bird heralds me? Candy that melted in the window.
Hello again, esteemed officer, and welcome to Crime Romance, a book about cockatoos. There should be one upstairs, right next to the shelf of biographies.
Cool.
A sulfur-crested cockatoo sits on the cover, its beak slightly open. It looks as if the bird is calling out the book title. Turns out that there are so many different cockatoo species, and they all have behavioral problems.
They have behavioral problems. Fantastic.
You don't have behavioral problems. That's garbage. It turns out that there are... You don't have behavioral...
You've acquired an interactable item. Investigate this item further by going to the in-
I've never seen it do that before.
A cockatoo is a parrot with an erectile crest found on the Seminole Islands and in southern Fas a la Mer. Known for their intelligence and general precociousness, cockatoos are popular birds in agriculture. However, they often exhibit various behavioral issues. This book talks about the delicate nature of twos, as well as introducing some of the most popular species among the bird enthusiasts. The funeral cockatoo, the major majestic cockatoo, and the most common bang bang cockatoo. It's colorfully illustrated. Where to even begin? All cockatoos are known for their needy natures, requiring attention for at least 2 full hours a day. They love to talk and have been described as lovable clowns who just don't know how to wrap up. Pet owners also report moodiness, loudness, and hostility as recurring issues. If left unsatisfied, cockatoos may scream non-stop, pluck their feathers, or become aggressive. It is not recommended to get a cockatoo if you're not able to cook them food every day and give them the full care that they need. These birds will never understand that you have a life of your own. You're right. Cockatoos are magnificent creatures. They love to perform, cuddle, and show off, and will even scream for fun, often as loud as up to 135 decibels.
Wow, that's loud.
Ouch. That must hurt. Not great for the neighbors. Performing? Yes. Birdie. This is a yellow-tailed black cockatoo. Its specific name, Sitarcus planarius, relates to its dark, somber plumage. This bird looks as if dressed for a funeral, 24/7. There is something indisputably ominous about it. Perhaps the most impressive of all the species, the endangered major majestic cockatoo, is often described as the most flamboyant bird in the jungle. Its pink-colored wings and flowing crest embellishing its proud and bumptious nature. In the words of poet-explorer Sir James Fournier, few birds more enliven the monotonous hues of the verdant forest than this big, bold, and beautiful species. Despite its banging name, the bang-bang cockatoo is actually the shyest of the species, common in almost all Seminese forests, as well as zoos and homes all over the world. Its plumage is mainly gray and white. The Seminese name, Bang Bang, is thought to be of onomatopoeic origins. Yes, but all those cockatoo species are so different. Which one are you? You're right. Your Majesty embodied. This big, beautiful bird belongs on your heraldry.
Mission accomplished.
Oop. Don't want to tear that down. That rain sounds relaxing. I wanted to tell her what kind of bird I was. Gonna decide that this guy's her husband. Part of me wants to do it and try to see if what happens.
most talkative one? The what now? You truly are one strange cop, aren't you?
The woman before you nods.
Yep. I'm strange and awesome. Let's see. We still have like 8 hours in game.
This coin operated viewer. This coin operated viewer is facing south. Why place a tourist attraction in the middle of such poverty?
There was a revitalization project in 49. The design studio tried restoring Martinet. They got as far as the street lamps and that statue in the intersection before something went south. I suspect it was Erasclair's doing. Muscle them up. That's how it usually goes around here.
Cool, I dig organized crime. It's the best.
We should have done something about the union 10 years ago. That ship has sailed, officer.
Your money disappears into the coin. The curtains on the display open. You lean in to catch the view. The lenses shift. The ghost sharpens into an islet in the bay. In the ruins, a man, it looks as if it was abandoned quite some time ago.
Really? I don't have the eyesight to make it out.
Low XP. Looking for bottles as we run around. A plastic bottle.
Of course, detective. Excuse me.
The RCM does not pick sides in this. I hope it doesn't come off any other way.
Of course. I don't expect you to share anything he told you with me. I'm not a corrupt verm myself. How can I stop you? Are we not human? Are we not curious?
Intellectually speaking, it would be quite interesting to hear what she has to say about.
Sounds like he has you running errands, detective. A well-established dominance ritual. Ah, yes. I've been meaning to go there.
Mm-hmm.
With longing. Clear and simple longing. Strange. Why does she want to go there?
I should be. In my youth, I had a brief dalliance here in Martinez. He was an older man with impossibly broad shoulders. He's probably dead by now. Even his shack is long gone. That it matters. Yes, I was slumming it with some girlfriends of mine. We had boats and... Don't hold it against me. My paramour certainly did not. Not overly so. It's not like this was the only place we visited. Me and my girlfriends from Azon with our shiny boats. Like reavers, we told ourselves we were the worst thing to happen to the coast since the Coalition landed in 08. Imagine. A youth center with Edgar Clare's statue on top of it. Go ahead. Help him. Make it so. I have no power to stop him. Yes. I'm sad I'll never have the time, detective. I've always wanted...
She is more defensive about it than usual.
Full of ghosts and ancient memories. Has this errand yielded you any... a referral, you mean? I take it this was for someone in the RCM.
Don't answer that. Oh my.
The lieutenant does not say anything, but you hear the nylon of his jacket rustle as he looks at you.
That's good to hear, detective. Police work is...
Her bartering mind cannot fathom that you didn't ask anything in return.
Frankly, what was done was not pretty at all, but neither was it illegal, and it was not fun. I advise you to be very selective with what information you choose to share.
He means beyond the coming days and weeks, or the grasp of newspaper and radio reports that may trickle to your desk if you ever return to Precinct 41 in the far future.
The company did not send mercenaries after the Union. I told you in great detail about the mistakes my... I just hope you don't share Everard's view on things. After all, as he said, one's dead now. The Pine certainly hasn't killed any of theirs.
Yet.
Let's keep it that way. She means to add, but then doesn't.
Naturally, detective. Of course, until then, is there anything I can help you with?
Wow, so someone's been a little... Yes, my standard liege. Someone seen all sorts of wild ideas pop off and thought, I'll take the boring one. The regular, please. The brown. No need to be defensive. The regularity, the brownness, the cut and dry have their
appeal. You?
See? You're so regular and vinyl brown, he doesn't even want to talk to you. Of course you do. Let's get right to it. My lord's copper type is regular copper. Done and done. No.
I don't know what I did there, but... I mean, other than bringing in that... Okay. Until I figure out how to pick up more things, I'm just collecting thoughts at this point. Do 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 do. Okay. Can we kill time? We have a book to read.
A cockatoo is a parrot with an... This book talks about the delicate nature. Where to even begin? Pet owners also... It is not... Where to even begin? All cockatoos are known for their pet owners. It is not... It is...
Just advancing the time. Look at that. Scam the system. Almost there. Gotta get after 2100.
Where to even begin? Pet owners. It is not re- where to pet owners. It is not where pet owners. It is not recommended to get a cockatoo if you're not.
Hi, he's here.
John DeMarie, you found me.
His slender figure is backlit by city lights, its distant streets and motorways flashing like diamonds.
It was mine. My friends use it from time to time to visit me. So tell me, are you here to make things right? Beautiful. I have some good news for you. My Sunday friend is visiting me tonight. I told him about you and he'd like to say hello. Step in. He's already waiting. Mm-hmm. That's why I chose this place. Martinez is special, isn't it?
Wait. Suddenly you're digging the thing?
That's nice, but I don't have anything to tell you. It's my friend you're looking for, not me.
He takes another drag off his unfiltered cigarette and looks around. It's getting dark in the neighboring windows. Downstairs, a cat crosses the yard, disappearing into the bush.
Besides, I've got to run.
Something tells you you're never going to talk to an individual this cool or mysterious ever again.
Just look at it. It's a beautiful night. Who's going to stay in on a night like this?
Something flutters in the corner of the lieutenant's mouth as you're saying those words.
We'll talk. Just not tonight. Take care, alright?
Alright, new skill point. What do we want? What do we want to drop it into?
Right after you.
I'm gonna forget advanced race theory as soon as I can. There's the Sunday friend. Have a little talk with him. Or her. I assume it to him. I thought they said him. Exquisite, made of metal.
our citizens' mission.
His hands are clean and well manicured. This is a man who knows the importance of appearances.
Hmm.
My name is Charles Villedroit, and I am an official with the coalition government. I work for the Institute of High Studies. I heard you talking to my friend outside. Very good. Super. I am here to assist you in any way possible.
Hanging? What's a drag? He seems like a cultured gentleman. You should ask him about the finer things.
Oh, yes. My friend has a great eye for this. He refuses to tell me where I came from. It's a mystery. I believe they call this.
That is an odd thing. Some people are better with their phones, though. My kids, they're way better with the phone keyboard than they are with an actual keyboard. Life lived with a phone glued to their hand.
I remember that first they came in, carrying what looked like a body. And then I saw all the surrounding windows.
Oh, that's weird. That is very strange.
That's when I understood. I should not be seen.
Sounds like the victim was unconscious, or at least incapacitated. Well done, detective.
I couldn't tell you exactly. Less than 10. Maybe 8?
The lieutenant sends you a sharp look at the mention of that number.
I went back inside.
Were you able to see anything from inside?
Officer, the yard was pitch black. There was nothing to see. But I could still hear their voices. They were threatening to kill that woman. All men, I presume. But again, I couldn't see them. Well, that's the strangest part. Nothing happened. It was oddly quiet.
Interesting.
Eventually, their shouts died down, and that was all. There were no gunshots, no celebratory shouts, no anything. I'm afraid I don't have anything else to add.
Okay, there you go.
About what time was all this happening, approximately?
All I can say is that it was late. No, I didn't see the corpse until the following day. Of course, anything I can do to assist the RC. The coalition is only looking out for the price tag. Inflation is a killer, like a heart disease blocking the normal circulation of the economy. It must be controlled. The economy impacts the entire international community, which is why it requires international oversight. Well, I'm renovating. It is an interesting project. The building used to be a 12-story skyscraper before the cannons took the top 4 stories off. This, of course, happened when the coalition forces landed here. You could say I'm undoing some of the material damage the international community caused when we arrived here. La communauté internationale is what Rivacholians colloquially call the coalition. In other words, the nations that stopped the disaster of the revolution. Your employer, technically speaking. The governing authority of Rivachon. Whatever you wish, officer. Ah, my friend. My friend is a good young man. His family immigrated here from Canada, and life has not been easy for him. But he understands the importance of education. Kedra is a candidate member of APIS. But between you and me, their potential membership is a more contentious issue. That it's never going to happen. They entered negotiations in 21, and it's been pending ever since. It's war. It's also known for its mandarin trees and dust storms from the Supra Moon. Kedra's an emerging market, but it still has a long way to go. Maybe that's why my friend's menage decided to win. How did any of us become friends? Bad things happening on the Isle de Sola. Oil platforms ablaze in the night. Civil wars lasting au contraire.
Bigger picture.
It's how I came here, and my friend. Sorry.
Who?
What I told you, officer. He's a bright young man here to pursue his education. Education is the foundation of officer. You have to understand. I can't give you his personal information. He's deeply enmeshed in the study of the fine arts.
As though you weren't envious enough of the boy as is.
He's a truly free spirit. She likes all the arts. Perhaps graphic design, printmaking, who knows? The world is open.
Bastard, he's got the world wide open, what? What's that like?
I'm just enjoying the view.
The dead body we still need to get down, by the way.
Listen.
The baby is crying in the neighboring apartment.
No, listen. The Insulindian Bay. This place used to be a luxury accommodation before the revolution. Apartments, of course, were much bigger then. A few walls had been added here and there, leaving some of the tenants without a private bathroom, a kitchen.
That's lame.
But the million real views stay. You can't take that. My friend comes and goes.
A busy bee.
I'm all ears. A moment. Do you have everything you need from me? I'm afraid we won't have the chance to speak again once you leave. It's against diplomatic best practices for an official in my position to be discussing murders with the local militia.
That's not the real reason he's so apprehensive. Men in his position shouldn't be seen loitering around in.
Sure, go ahead. Was there anything else? The coalition, the economy impacts the entire international. Yes, as I said before. I'm a commissioner from...
Wait, there isn't actually an Institute of Price Stability, is there? Or maybe there is. God, it's impossible to understand whether someone from the moral intern...
It is the most important. It's the central goal of any sound monetary policy. Maintaining the price stability is essential to maintaining high levels of economic activity, which is essential for maintaining the social stability.
Basically, it makes sure the price of bread doesn't change.
Precisely. Too much inflation, bread becomes too expensive. Too much deflation, it becomes too cheap for bakers. That's why the Institute of Price Stability works to keep inflation just below 2%. Not too far below, no. Too below is also bad. Below, but close to 2%.
Economics, man.
The coalition believes in the importance of informing the public about the benefits of the price stability. Transparency is one of a sound monetary policy. But I don't have my leaflets on me today. It's the International Organization for Moralists, hence Moralist International. The Institute of Price Stability is just
mind babies.
Mind babies, as is the coalition.
There are more nefarious powers to work for in the moral.
But of course. Well, do you value freedom? Do you believe in a normal, stable world governed by democratic values? Martinez? No. Martinez. Rivachol is generally difficult. But they are working towards it. You're all doing very well here, relatively speaking.
The detective's personal views do not represent the views of the RCM.
Biggest communism builder. I wonder what that trophy's for.
My friend. But the lesson of the revolution is that communism does not work. Ah, yes. The unattainable ideal. Never settle for less. Good luck with that. Now, enough of this delightful political interview. What's there to say? Sur la clé is a modern, urbanized country. Measures very high on the human development and freedom. Moreover, it is a great sponsor of less emerged countries. Rivachol is...
Darling, that can't be an official designation.
Because a great percentage of Rivachol's culture hails from Sur-la-Clé. Its language, its people, cuisine, even. Or at least in the downtown Ladelta area.
Jamron and other parts of the international zone have been mercifully spared of Sela Clay's love for meatballs and mashed potatoes.
Whatever you wish, officer.
Of course.
Got everything we're gonna get. Oh wow, it's 10 o'clock already. There's our 3 hours for the night. I could go longer, but then I'd just end up losing sleep. Yeah, thanks for joining me, Bounty Hunter. I hope your Destiny was fun. I haven't played that game in a very, very long time. But, yeah, I'm going to hop off. I just saved the game off camera, and I'm shutting it down. I won't be back till Wednesday night. I'm not sure what we're going to stream, but we will be back Wednesday night at 7. I'm not canceling this week. But yeah, I'm going to hop off. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for watching later if you're watching this later on YouTube or even here on Twitch. And I will see you soon.